Hello everyone and welcome back to the show. Today on your daily starter, let's talk about how you can succeed even if you've got no talent. If you think you've got no talent, you've got no flair for things, I believe that with this simple two-step process, you can make massive success. Hello friend, this is the voice of Ademola Webji. Hello friend, I believe strongly that you can succeed in anything you set your mind to do, regardless of having no talent, no skills or whatever, right? I believe that it comes down to two things, and once I share it with you now, I can assure you that if you go out there and do the work, you're going to get the results, okay? So the first thing is modeling, and the second thing is accountability. With modeling and accountability, I believe that you can get a foothold on the road of success. Modeling simply means that, you know, the idea is that you go out there and look for what works, what has been proven to work, right? And once you know what works, you simply have to do it. Amen. You're going to get some results, isn't it? So think about it. Now, the things you want to do are probably things that has been done over and over and over and over again, right? I mean, no matter how novel you think what you want to do, no matter how new you think and all that, the chances that someone has done it before is mostly approximately one, right? Somebody somewhere has done that thing before and they've actually succeeded at that thing, right? And people have done those things before and they failed at that thing as well. So look at those that have failed and look at those that succeeded, right? So those that failed, they'll give you what not to do, and those that succeed, they'll give you what to do. It's as simple as that. So for example, if I told you that I don't feel talented enough to drive, you would laugh me out of the room, isn't it? Like, what do you mean? You say you're not having the talent to drive? Can't see, people are driving. People smarter than you, they drive. People not as smart as you, they can't drive. So how are you going to tell me you can't drive, right? You want to start a business? You're telling me you can't start a business because you're not smart enough? What are you talking about? People smarter than you, they started businesses. People that are not as smart as you, they started successful businesses and they are cashing in day in and day out. So definitely, the problem is not a lack of talent. The problem is you don't know what to do. As simple as that. But if there was a recipe you could follow, right? If there was a recipe you could follow, like, this is the three-step process, this is a five-step process, follow this seven-step process and you're going to bake a cake, right? Follow the seven-step process, you're going to start a business. Follow the seven-step process and you're going to, you know, graduate to the good grade in school, something like that, right? So all you have to do is to find out what works, right? And model it in your own life, right? I'm cautious to call it copy what works, because honestly, it's not about copying what works, because you can't really copy it anyway, right? But you model it. So you do what, you know, what you see them do, you do it in your own way, right? Okay, so they did this, you also do the same thing. They took this step, you take the same step, right? So when you model what works, you are able to get started, right, with the things you want to do with your life. And that is where accountability comes in, right? Accountability is key. Accountability is very, very important, right? One of my top beliefs is the idea that your next level will require more accountability than your current level, right? That if you are more accountable, then you can make better progress, isn't it? Okay, so accountability is important. So you have to look for accountability partners. Accountability is important because a lot of times, we are not yet matured enough to honor deadlines that we set for ourselves. So when we told ourselves, I'm going to get this thing done by next week, honestly, without an accountability partner, it becomes hard for you to actually own up to that. So of course, you could develop capacity, develop maturity, and honor deadlines you set for yourself, right? And that is important, and you should be thinking of doing that. But in the interim, you should get an accountability partner that can hold you accountable to the things you say. So when you say you're going to complete that manuscript by next week Thursday, you tell someone that, look, hey, I said I'm going to finish my manuscript by next week Thursday. You know, you're reading a book, you're having a hard time finishing the book, so you tell someone, I've committed to finish this book in 3 weeks' time, right? So your accountability partner. So if you can learn how to model success and be accountable to somebody, I'm so sure, right, that you are going to get closer to the kinds of success that you want in your life. Modeling and accountability, they are key concepts that I believe that any serious-minded person should embrace. So all you have to do is stop saying you don't have talent, stop saying you don't have the skills. All you have to do is to find out what works. Find out a step-by-step process that works. Once you find that, you repeat it in your own life and you have accountability partners, you are good. You are good to go and you are going to begin to experience success in your life. Why don't you repeat after me this morning? Say, God daily loads me with benefits. I am bold and strong. Every day, In every way, I am getting better and better. My name is Ademola Merebishe. Thank you so much for taking our time to check out this video. Remember, you can lead a formidable life. Have a great day.